Much of the co-governance debate stems from Te Urewera and the government's co-governing proposal in the Three Waters reforms. And those are unique in a sense in that they concern co-governance over public services. But there are already several co-governing arrangements established between Māori and the Crown over Te Taiao, the environment, as a result of treaty settlements. Ngāi Tūhoe's, for example, is a unique relationship, allowing for the co-governance of Te Urewera. Whena Owen went to the Tūhoe heartland to see how it works.
Te Urewera, a vast expanse of rainforest and its gem within Wai Karemoana. When a road was cut through, tourists ventured in.
Lake Wai Karemoana lies in the heart of the Dominion's North Island. To reach it, a scenic drive takes us through rugged bushlands.
And it lies in the homeland of Tūhoe, but there was little consultation in the 1950s when the government declared this area to be Urewera National Park.
Look at this. It's easy to see why this was a prize public asset. In 2014, Te Urewera ceased to be a national park, and of course now it's managed by Ngāi Tūhoe in partnership with the Crown. How's it working?
The Department of Conservation and Tūhoe, they do come from different places.
Tūhoe's Te Uru Taumatua chairman, Tamati Kruger.
Ideologies, philosophy, culture, language, practice. And so in the 7 years we have found the collision points of those, and we've tried our very best, both parties, to work those things out.
So this year Tūhoe leadership is keen to meet formally with the Crown to review their relationship.
So that's what we are planning to do this year of 2022, is Tūhoe and the Crown sitting down and having an honest assessment of how our post-settlement relationship have carried on. And both of us, I think, are willing to work on improving it.
So there have been challenges?
There have been exams without notification.
The past year has been a challenge. While Te Urewera is now open to visitors, the Wai Karemoana Great Walk and Lake was closed for 6 months because of COVID and urgent repairs needed on tracks and huts.
These were legitimate reasons. These were not fake.
Have you been accused of fake?
Yes. We have been accused of not being genuine, that somehow we were playing political games.
The Crown's relationship with Ngāi Tūhoe, although highly valued, remains a sensitive one. The Minister of Conservation and her department declined an interview with Q&A about how the co-governing around Te Urewera is tracking.
Co-governance is not our term. Mana motuhake is our term. So we are committed to washing away dependency on the Crown and raising maximum autonomy for Tūhoe people.
The iwi works alongside many government agencies in collaborative projects like the three Tūhoe health centres and a roading project with Waka Kotahi. Tūhoe is also working with police to eliminate meth in their communities.
You wouldn't believe it, that, but after Operation 8, the so-called terror raids, we now enjoy a really good relationship with the New Zealand police.
In Taniatua, an eco-village is fast taking shape. Built by Tūhoe tradies, it's the first of a projected 40 villages in the Rohe.
Building villages will give us the basis for rebuilding hapu, whānau and iwi. So it's not really a response to a housing crisis, rather a cultural crisis.
What do you want? Where do you want it?
Yesterday!
For Tamati Kruger and those who share his vision, the challenges have also been from within, some kaumātua and hapu questioning decisions.
Yes, of course, there is disagreement. because you're dealing with generations. Generations of being not who you are.
In a recent move, Tūhoe leadership is now meeting directly with heads of relevant government agencies. Having helped forge Tūhoe's partnerships with the Crown, Tamati Kruger is keenly observing the co-government debate beyond Tūhoe territory.
I am sad that there are people that are frightened by it, that see that as some kind of robbery, that it will steal something from them, it will take something from them. It is not. It's not robbery. It's not theft. I don't see it as the final destination. I don't see co-governance as the answer, but I think it's the next bus stop in a journey that has to be made. It's everyone's journey. It's like gravity. It's you can't defy it. It's on its way. Yeah.